the people without more material. So this is a lesson for the rest of the artists to learn not to take our people for granted. It is always good to give it time. Do more music, make more news, make it more interesting, and then come back. Then the people will always find a reason to come and support you. Ladies and gentlemen, why the Golden Heart? One morning, I came back around 4 o'clock, sleeping in my bed. My wife always wakes up, Zuena wakes up, either to make the cakes or to prepare the kids in the morning. And then she takes the kids to school. So on her way, opening the gates, there's a very, very, you know, young lady crying, kneeling down in the middle of the way when the gate is open and the car cannot get out. And then my wife came out and asked her, what's the problem? Can you please get on the side, we talk? She said, no, I'm not allowing this car to get out. I need to talk to Bebe. My wife had to wake me up, very angry. I believe the whole press knows Bebe Cool's temper. You assume to know, but I'm a good guy anyway. Don't worry about that. So I definitely jumped out of the bed because I had just had like 2 hours of sleep and came to find out who the hell is stopping my car from leaving the house. Probably it can be a security threat or something. But as I walked to the lady, I saw a lady kneeling down with a child. And the child was nearly dying. So I definitely knew there's something about help. I asked her, what's the problem? She said, I want your help. I need your help. I asked her, can we please go on the side? Let these people go so we can talk. And not going through the whole story, but the most important part of that story is I asked her, what's wrong with the child? She says, the child has a very complicated heart problem. I asked her, what do you want from me? She's like, I need your help. I need an air ticket to go to India. I asked her, what? An air ticket? Yes. I asked her, do you have the money to treat you or to treat the child? She's like, yes, I have a person who has promised to pay the hospital. All I need from you is an air ticket. I said, no, you're lying. That's not possible. She said, yes, I have the number to the person. So I called this gentleman. This gentleman belongs to, he runs an NGO called ACFOD, Action for Disadvantaged something. Now, I asked her, are you sure you're going to pay for the hospital, this child? The gentleman is like, yes. All you want from me is just the air ticket? The gentleman is like, yes. I said, okay, can we please meet? This gentleman explained to me the whole process. Ladies and gentlemen, if you think Bebe Cool can be an angel to save people, I think there are better people who Ugandans must know. People who do good things in this country. And on this day of the concert, I'm going to introduce to you this gentleman. So that the country can know, so that companies can know the right people to support, the right people to back up. Because they do things for the same people that we want to help, the Ugandan person. Ladies and gentlemen, what broke my heart was, as I jumped out of bed to come and meet this lady, my little son, he's 2 years old, he's called Baby Dean, followed me naked, just with a pamper, running, no shoes, no anything. And then when he came, he did stand next to me. Baby Dean went straight past me onto the child. At that moment, all the anger I had for waking up, for this lady telling me, trying to stop the car, disappeared. Because imagine if a 2-year-old kid can go direct onto a sick child. Then how about you who has developed brains? So it was like God was speaking to me immediately there. He was like, your son is telling you something. I did not ask much. I made the decision. I called one of my workmates. I told him, look, you know what? I think let's kick off the concert this year. And let's name the concert the Golden Heart. I have a child here. We need to do something. So I told this gentleman, I'm going to test you. If I buy the air ticket and everything, and the child goes for the operation, and the child comes back to Uganda, for the rest of my life, I'm going to be doing concerts, and every concert I do, I'll be sending a minimum of 3 kids to India, personally. So ladies and gentlemen, we went ahead and the first child, Sheila, went to India 2 months ago, and Sheila, ladies and gentlemen, came back to Uganda 2 weeks ago after a very successful heart operation. Sheila, or this gentleman, only goes around the country to look for kids with the most complicated heart issues. Not just complicated, because some of you would ask and say, okay, they are now operating in Mulago or Kenya or where. But this is what happens to Omuntu Awansi. They give birth to kids, and when they go to hospital and they find those very complicated problems, they give up and they just wait for those kids to die. So what this gentleman does, he goes all over the country to look for those most complicated heart problems. Sheila had the most complicated heart problem. She could become blue, the whole body. So I spoke to the doctors in India, and they're like, we're going to have two different operations for Sheila, one now and one after 1 year. So you can see the direction of where we're heading. A second air ticket will still come, and for Sheila, fortunately, it's ready already. But before Sheila goes back, I told this gentleman that now that Sheila is back, let's go to my concert and send 5 more children 2 weeks after the concert. 5 more kids. So ladies and gentlemen, allow me to tell you that the Golden Heart concert is sending another 5 children 2 weeks after the concert to India. There's nothing that makes me happy and proud like being a person who helps, not one who talks about health, but actually one who delivers health. It actually describes the difference between Bebe Cool and Sally Moses. And that is the two people. Right now, the Golden Heart is Sally Moses. And when we get to Bebe Cool, I know you'll ask me the questions and I'll answer them. But welcome to the Golden Heart concert. Third, the Golden Heart concert has been amazing since we started advertising it on social media and everywhere on the radios. People are responding way too positively than I expected. That we have been forced to think about the venue. The venue is so small, but as the time I speak today, 40 tables are already gone, 2 weeks before. And you all know that those 40 tables, in Serena you can only have 50 tables at most. Remember, I have my biggest sponsors and they sit big. So that means I was left with no single table to sell. On that note, I decided to change the venue to Kololo Airstrip. So the concert has moved from Serena to the first time ever artists to perform in the dome at Kololo Airstrip. What I mean with the dome is you'll find a very big tent in form of a dome. The concert is indoor. The concert is fully branded inside, but this time bigger. And the advantage to it is even the performance, the ambience is good, the performance changes. At Serena, I'm so predictable, there's only one direction I can come from. And there's only one direction I can go. But now, this is free and easily planable. Access roads. There are so many roads that you can use to access Kololo Airstrip. Security. There's beautiful ample security. Weather. Controllable, even if it rains, your shoes are safe. Your cars, so every advantage is at Kololo Airstrip. And ladies and gentlemen, it is now bigger and better. And I'm so proud to say, I took so long to tell my big sponsors that I always come up with surprises. They're still coming, surprises are still coming.